Good afternoon. I'm so glad that you could make our consultation appointment today. Now, I understand that you spoke with my associate up front and she did show you the facility, is that correct? Alrighty. So what did you think? Yes, we are very state of the art here, using all the highest tech equipment. That's right, and our air circulation does include HEPA filters in each room. Okay, so yeah, as you've taken a look at our doggy hotel, I hope that you have found it to be quite pleasing and suitable for your needs. And as you know, not a lot of people choose to board their dog. However, for some people's lifestyle, it is a way for them to live a very convenient and safe life. Now, with our dog boarding services, we do make sure that your loved one is completely monitored 24/7. You know that you can access our cameras in every single room while you are away. And we have lots of add-on services that I'm going to tell you about as we continue this discussion. Have you looked into other dog hotels or boarders? You have, okay. And what brought you here? Okay, it was recommended. Alrighty. Well, let's go ahead and get started. And what I'm going to do is we're going to begin by talking about the general information of your pet. And then we're going to get into some more specifics around cost and other services that we provide. Okay? So let's start with this. Now, before we begin, I am going to get a complete profile. Let's just see what pen I'm going to use. Let's see. Okay, let's do this one. Okay, so for this information, can I please have, now we're going to start with your information. Can I have your last name, please? Okay. Okay, and your first name, spell it for me, please. What a beautiful name. Okay. And your phone number? Area code first. Okay. And do you have a house number as well? You do? Wow. Not many people do these days. Okay, go ahead with that one. Alrighty. And your email? gmail.com, okay. And your mailing address. Okay, great. And what city is that? Okay. Zip code. Great. And what is the name of your precious dog? Max. Okay. And is that male or female? It's a male. And is Max spayed or neutered? Okay, yes. He is. Okay. And what is Max's primary breed? Okay, golden retriever. Okay, what a sweet breed. Is he mixed with anything? Okay. And the color? Of course, it's that beige. Light brown even? Okay. Light brown. And how much approximately does Max weigh? Okay. 30 pounds. Okay. Maybe he's a little young. And when was Max born? He was born July 4th, okay, in 2016, so he is quite young, alrighty. And has your dog lived with you for less than a month? No, he has not, okay. And what would be an emergency contact? Alrighty. phone number? Great. And your veterinarian's name, address, and phone number, please. Okay. That is perfect. Vet. The address is 1213 Sad Street. Okay. What an interesting name. Okay, and that's in the same city already. Same zip code, I presume. Very good. Okay. And what's that vet's phone number? Okay. 5555. Good. Okay. So now I've got your basic information here. Now we're going to take a little shift into the diet, alrighty? We're going to be talking a little bit about what your dog's diet is and what his needs are. And again, this is just for us to get a clear idea of what it might be like for Max to stay with us. So, will you be bringing his food to stay here when you drop him off? Yes, that's absolutely preferable. Your dog should absolutely not be changing up their diet just based off of where they're staying. So, you know, in cases where a dog does not have their food, we sort of have the guest circle, which they would like their dog to eat, and it's $5 per day, but that does not seem to apply to you. So in the event that we run out of the provided dog food that Max will have, can you please tell me which food you would like for us to feed him? Now we have Iams Puppy, Iams Mini Chunk, Iams Senior, Nutro Puppy, Nutro Small Adult Bites, Nutro Senior, or House Organic. Okay. So you want the Iams Mini Chunk, alrighty. And how many times a day would you like your dog to be fed? Twice a day, And I'm assuming that's morning and evening, right? Okay. Now, shifting to your dog's medical needs, is your dog allergic to any type of food? No, of course, other than foods that dogs absolutely don't eat, like chocolate and grapes and things like that, Is your dog allergic to any medication? Okay, he is. And what is that? That's the Advantage flea drops. Yeah, I've heard a lot of cases of that lately. Okay. Now, does your dog have any old or current injuries or health concerns? Yes. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Okay, he had an ear infection 6 months ago. Alrighty. Ear infection 6 months ago. And what was the result of that? Was he medicated? Okay, medicated and it resolved? Oh, good. All right. Do you know what solved it? I mean, what caused it? Trapped water. Okay. Okay. Now, is he taking any medications? This does include his flea medication regimen. He is. Okay, and what's he taking? Okay, Comfortis. One time a month. And when do you give him that medication? The first of the month. Okay, so we have it administered. First of the month. And did he get it for this month? Now, does your dog engage in any unusual or repetitive behaviors like excessive digging in the backyard, excessive humping of objects or people or other animals, excessive chewing on any items, scratching? No. Okay. Now, kind of in that same area of behavior, I'm going to ask you a little bit more about Max's behavior. Now, is he house trained? He is. Very good. And has he had any obedience training? He has. Okay, now has that been at home, or did he have a class, or did you hire a professional trainer? He had a class. Very good. And did he graduate? Oh, that's great. He was the top of his class. How cute is that? Graduated top of his class. How sweet. Okay. So I'm going to list some of these personalities, and I want you to tell me about if they apply to your dog or not. Outgoing, verbally sensitive, timid, affectionate. Okay, affectionate, pushy, independent, reserved, confident, okay, confident, clingy, excitable, playful, okay, playful, gentle or mouthy, gentle, okay. Now, can you describe Max's activity level, please? Low, medium, or high? Medium, okay. And how would you describe your dog's demeanor while riding in the car? Does he enjoy it, dislike it, or is he neutral? Neutral, okay. And does your dog defecate or vomit while riding in the car? Yes, okay. What happens? Sometimes he vomits, okay. Now, have you ever tried to withhold food from him before going into the car? Yeah, I highly suggest that you don't feed him in the morning if you're going to be driving soon after that, because sometimes, just like humans, they might get a little bit car sick, in which case he would be getting an upset tummy and he would vomit up his breakfast. Yes. Okay. Now, does your dog normally ride in a crate while in the car? No. Okay. At feeding times, does your dog eat slow or fast? Slow, okay. Have you ever boarded your dog before? And if yes, please describe the experience. You have not, okay. So I'd like for you to tell me where your dog might become unfriendly. I'm going to name some areas and you're going to tell me yes or no. Will he become unfriendly if his collar is grabbed? No. Hugging if he's being hugged? No. Removing from furniture? No. Touching while sleeping? No. Touching ears, paw, mouth, or tail? No. Around other dogs? No. Anything else that is particular to your dog and he when he becomes unfriendly? Okay. No. Okay. Now, let's see. That's NA. Okay, that's NA. Now, has your dog ever bitten somebody? No. And has your dog ever bitten another dog? No. Good. Okay. So that completes the first phase of this consultation. So I'm looking over here our house rules and then also our stay, hotel stay and service agreement, which we only have you sign upon your decision to keep the dog here. And it talks a little bit about what's required when making your reservation, okay? So I want to let you know that upon making a reservation, a room can only be guaranteed if the reservation is confirmed in advance, okay? And a reservation can only be confirmed if the following is on file, and that is a valid credit card, proof of current vaccinations, and a signed copy of our house rules, services, and stay agreement, as well as the guest profile, okay? And I do want you to know that check-in and check-out is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Our room rates for a full night are incurred on a 24-hour basis at the time of check-in, okay? Half-day room rates are incurred for each 12 hours beyond the 24 hours. So a no-show reservation is defined as more than 4 hours, okay? I really want to highlight that for you. So a no-show is considered 4 hours after the scheduled check-in time. Okay, so if you do not come within 4 hours of the time that we scheduled, that is considered a no-show, at which time the room will be released and your reservation will be canceled. And for reservations 20 nights or more, require 50% deposit at the time of booking. And reservations will be canceled due to non-performance by clients with regard of vaccinations and credit card. So if we don't have those on a file, then we will cancel the reservation. Okay, so I do want to let you know with regard to some health issues regarding your pets, this hotel will not accept any pets that have terminal illness or in the late stages of that illness, okay? And we also do not accept any guests that require medical treatment beyond the dispensing of oral and topical medications. So we would not do something like an injection, a drain, a bandage change, or suture removal. And of course, we make sure that the all guests are medicated with flea and tick medication as needed. Okay, and we need to make sure that our guests must be 4 months or older for dogs, and there must be proof of current vaccination, of course, and that's for rabies, DHPP, and Bordetella. The Bordetella must be administered at least 7 days prior to check-in if it has expired, okay? And we do need the vaccination documentation confirmed 3 days before check-in, okay? So let me just make sure. Now, for special holidays, we do have a minimum stay requirement that I can go over with you if you'd like. We do have play groups that are designed based on different dog behavior and personalities. Okay. So before I have you sign that, because what I would like for you to do is to take this home and read it nice and thoroughly before signing. I wanted to go over with you just a few little things that we offer here, all right? Now, in addition to boarding, we also offer daycare and just a day stay. We also offer full grooming and training, okay? And the philosophy here is really that of fun, that our staff hails from the best animal science programs in the country and is dedicated to providing a safe, fun, and loving experience for your pet. Safety and comfort is a priority for us, and I want you to know here at this doggy hotel, our science-based approach incorporates the latest research into our methodologies to ensure a safe, comfortable, and low-stress experience for your guest, for your dog, and our guest. So professionally trained staff are on-site for 24 hours. Okay, and we have eco-friendly cleaning systems that utilize a continuous fresh air circulation to eliminate germs. Okay, I'm also going to include that in here. So for the daycare, okay, I wanted to tell you a little bit about this if you are interested. Now, for the daycare, the rates are as follows. Just for a standard day stay, so where you just stay and they do have access to a bed, a room service and meal, and two playgroup sessions, excuse me, at 8 a.m. and 2 p.m., that's 42 a day, okay? Now, if you wanted to purchase a 20-pack of that, it would be 635. If you wanted to purchase that monthly pack, it would be 585. If you'd like for the dog to have a special suite, so not just our standard room, instead of the $42, it would be $77. And then if you wanted that upgraded with the suite included, these are the prices follows. Okay. Now, if you had a dog that requires some specialized care, I want to just tell you some of these services that we offer for that. Now, some guests may be placed into specialized care for the following behavioral or medical reasons. That would be an intact male, okay, so a male that hasn't been neutered, an in-heat female, okay, if your dog is aggressive, if your dog has limited mobility, incompatible temperament or play style, excessive or complex medication of or feeding schedule, injuries or recent surgeries. So these are some reasons why your dog might be put into specialized care. Now, I don't think that applies to Max, but just for in the future. And you know, I would like to point out that not all dogs are suitable for a hotel environment, and this might be due to outdated vaccines. They might be sick, incontinent. They might require assistance to eat, drink, sit, or stand, and/or go to the bathroom. They might have little or no independent mobility, or they could be at very high likelihood of causing injury, or they're too aggressive, okay? So if you wanted to include the specialized care program, it is $50 per day. And what it includes is 3 20-minute private sessions with a staff member, all amenities included with our overnight or day stay program, and that's plush bedding, room service and meals, soothing music, and administration of medications if needed. Okay? Now, lastly, I want to tell you about our grooming that we do offer. These are some services you can get a la carte. So we do have a fur mask. So we could certainly have your pet have a foam mask scrub that exfoliates and hydrates, helps prevent future stains, and leaves your pet's face smelling delicious. Yes, that's for $10. We can also offer them a lemon sea salt bath with lemongrass extracts that have a calming effect on your pet. This is an antimicrobial formula which will help restore your pet's skin. That's $10. We also have the paw pad rub, which is softening the cracked, dry, weary pads of their paw, and that's oatmeal fragrance. We also offer the coconut oil silk treatment. This treatment penetrates the skin for ultra moisture, promoting epidermal growth and dermal thickness while enhancing hair growth for $13. And some of our fun things are listed here on the bottom: a pet tattoo, a temporary tattoo with 3 design options. Okay, that's $5, and you can choose from a heart, star, or skull and crossbones. We can also dye their hair or do a design. A temporary colorful addition to your pup, so we can give them a colorful tail, a mohawk, or color their feet for $25. Okay? All right, so that leads us to this last piece, which just talks about some of the extras in terms of the type of rooms that we offer. Okay, so for a small room, I know that the associate did talk to you about the different sizes, and that first time rate is a $52. Okay, now if your dog had a roommate, so if your dog lived with another dog, then it would go down to $41.50. Okay, in the event that you would like a bigger room for your dog, a medium-sized room, that would be $60. A large room is $70 a night. Okay, this does not include any extras. Then we have the deluxe suite for $98, and we have the ultra suite for $150. Okay. So I've put together this package for you to take home. I have included these two complimentary stickers. Now these go on the front of your window or any back doors. And this is to indicate to firefighters or policemen or anybody else rescuing anything in your house about how many pets are located in this home. Okay, so it has a spot here for the dogs up top and then for the cats down below. So you would indicate one dog or two cats and so on, and then leave your contact information there. So this is best to be put on your front window of the house and on the back window or door of your house, okay? Good. So I know that we covered quite a bit today. I hope that this provided you with some really great information and clarified any questions for you. Please take home this packet and review it. My information is inside if you have any further questions. It was my pleasure. Bye-bye.